Hello,
Can you hear me
hi.
now?
Can you hear us?
Yes, this time I can hear you
Yes.
well.
Okay, perfect. Thank you very much. Okay, so I'm here. I'm Marta Fernandez. I'm here with Karina López. She is the
Hey.
Digital Future Society think tank director.
And I'm
I
here
want to
with
choose Esteban
Aurora.
because he had. Hi, Aurora.
Hey. Hello, nice to
I
meet
wanted
you.
to excuse Esteban because he had to go to another meeting with the city council, with the Barcelona City Council. So just 5 minutes ago, she got a call from the city council, so he had to run away.
It's
So
okay, it's
sorry
okay.
about that. But we have Karina, which is the think tank director, and we will explain you a little bit more about Digital Future Society, the new program launched by Mobile World Capital and the Minister of Economy and Business from the Spanish government, the Catalonia government of Catalonia, the City Council, the Barcelona City Council, and FIRA and GCMA. So, and now Karina will explain you a little bit about what is Digital Future Society, which are our challenge, no, and opportunities with this project. And the main goal of this call is because we wanted to invite you to be one of the members of the Global Board of Trustees of this project, and also to invite you to join us in the Digital Future Society Summit in November, that you already told us that you will not be able to attend in person, but maybe we can find a way to, maybe we will be very honored to maybe to have your presentation there. So, but let's start, no,
Yeah,
with the
we
presentation of
can
the project,
always
and then we can.
do the telepresence, and we also have our local Taipei Economic and Culture Office team who can also help with the conversation. So you can always
Okay.
talk with a real people. It's just me that may be attached to another person.
Okay.
But I
Okay.
think you can begin the conversation. And just to let you know, we will be on the record, and on the end of the talk, we can decide to publish the video as is, or you want to edit the transcript, it's up to you. So please start.
Okay,
Yeah. Thank you. So as you may already seen, we sent you an executive summary of what the Digital Future Society is. This is a new, very ambitious initiative. We aim to be a global program that connects different actors at global scale. We're talking about experts, policymakers, civic entrepreneurs, and organizations, and we'll bring them together to address, understand, and engage with issues around the ethical, legal, and inclusion challenges that the digital transformation and the digital economy are presenting to us these days. As part of this initiative, we have three main verticals of action. It's a project that has been designed to be top down and bottom up at the same time. So one of the verticals is a think tank. So the think tank is about creating new knowledge in different areas that are very aligned with the challenges as perceived by society. So we'll be touching issues that are very close to the day-to-day of citizens. And the work of the think tank will be a lot of institutional work, but we'll be working really hard to bring that content and that generated knowledge to our streets, no? So the second vertical will be like a lab where we'll transfer knowledge into solutions. That can be prototypes, can be pilots, but the objective really is really to bring together best practices based on what other countries are already doing and how they are tackling the same challenges, but also develop new solutions for problems that are shared among different geographic regions and collectives. And the third vertical of this initiative is all the activities we'll do around citizen engagement. And we'll do those activities in Barcelona, but also across all the Spanish territory and Europe and anywhere we'll be invited to. But it's really about making sure that when we talk about technology and technological development, we're thinking about what's the impact, both the challenges and opportunities that this development is bringing to our society, and how us as a collective can address those challenges from an ethical and legal, but also inclusion and equitable perspective. So, we also mentioned very briefly in our executive summary, we'll have a transversal to all these three verticals, we'll have a very ambitious objective, which is to design and get together with institutions at global scale to design a new letter of human rights that includes the digital rights and really understand what should be the basic human digital rights. Because we know all the impact the digital is having in our lives and we want to have a voice and to have a human perspective on the technological development. And regarding the think tank and how we've been thinking and trying to structure what we want to present, you know, simplifying it a lot, you can say that when we talk about technology, we usually have this horizontal, linear narrative around the design of technology and then is put to use. And then lastly, usually try to govern the impact, negative or positive, of that technology. But we want to bring a more circular way, an engaging way, where when technology is being designed, it's really designed from the human perspective and addressing already the impact that technology is going to have on society and users. And not and to have technology not designed as thinking just about consumers, but as about all of us as a society and also talking about sustainability and so on. So the four main topics will be, very generic topics we'll be talking about, is about inclusion and citizen empowerment. And then we have, which is related with the relation between citizens and the technological development. And then we have public innovation, that's really about the challenges that the digital brings to policymakers and how we have to change the dynamic, the speed, but also the relations of engagement to design policy. And then we have an area about digital trust and security, and we are very concerned how the relations of also relations of power between small organizations and large organizations, and how small organizations can adapt to this new context, and how can we empower them. And this can be civic organizations, but also small companies, family companies, and so on, that in Spain are a very large percentage of the organizations we have and companies in the country. And then lastly, the fourth topic is a more global topic, and it's about equitable growth. So we want to make sure that when we talk about growth, we have a equitable perspective where no one is left behind, and that we always have a very inclusive and sustainable, in different perspectives, approach to development and growth. So those are the main topics. We'll engage with these topics with the support of a group of institutions from different parts of the globe within the think tank. And this content will always be transformed to arrive to the day-to-day of citizens, because sometimes some of the challenges we talk around digital, you know, they are translated in a very different way when they get to the day-to-day of the citizen, and sometimes we have to build this bridge, no? The challenges that the policymakers face and the citizen faces with the digital are different, but they are connected, and we have to create these bridges of and paths of communication. So this is, you know, a very brief description of what we are doing. I don't know if you have specific questions regarding the perspective, the approach, and so on.
Yes. I've read executive summaries, and it is very well written. So I think this idea of doing technology not for the people but with the people is very well aligned with our philosophy as well. I understand that GSMA is one, you know, patron or sponsor to this activity. As I understand, they also have many other activities, such as around sustainable development goals, such as in the EU, there's the Horizon Projects, Decent and Decode, and others focusing on, roughly speaking, the same goals. So what are your relationship with the EU and UN level organizations working on, roughly speaking, similar things?
Okay, so For example, with GSMI, we have a very close relationship. We work with them on different projects. So they'll be part of our global board of trustees, but also they'll be part of the think tank because they have units that are dedicated just to research and policy making. So we'll be working closely with them. And we are very aligned on assuring that, you know, the tech sector really thinks about development goals, and we work together in a productive, proactive way towards those goals. Regarding the European Commission, we have very close relationship with the City Council, and you know the City Council of Barcelona participates in projects like Decode through Francisca Bri and their team, and we work very close with them every day. We have projects on, for example, women and technology that are aligned with some of the projects that they are doing at European level. We also participate in a lot of European projects, and we are in close relationship conversations with the Commission to present the project, and also fully will get their support. And we have invited
The commissioners Gabriela, Maria, and Carlos Moedas. We have invited them also to be part of the Global Board of Trustees, and they are willing to be part as well. So
okay, that's great. That's great. So not only the values are aligned, but you're already working in a day-to-day kind of operation level with these people. That's very good to hear. Yeah. I have another clarifying question. So as part of this board of trustees, suppose that I agree, what are my, like, are there yearly or monthly obligations, and can I fulfill those obligations through telecommunication only?
Well, for us, the Global Board of Trustees is, we want them to support, to advise, and there is no a timing, you know, obligations, or it's very flexible. You mean, for example, we would like them to participate in our summits, but they can come, for example, if one in a year, or if they can come, a representative of them can come, or maybe they can just be online in a video conference. So there's no, we understand that these members, you know, they have a very thought agenda. So what we want for them is their expertise, their advice, their support, for example, with the think tank, with the principles, with the thematics, if we are going, you know, in the good path, or if we are in the good line. So it's more this advice point of view than no obligation of writing or sending reports or no.
Exactly.
It's only their advice and support and your expertise on these thematics, you know?
Exactly.
Okay. So is the society itself just a name of a project? Like, there's another team that I participate called the Global Council on Extended Intelligence, or Global CXI. Which is Joy Ito and IEEE and a bunch of friends, but there's no institution of it. It's just a bunch of people working on policy documents and suggestions and things like that. So are you institutionalized as a nonprofit or a foundation or some way, or is it really just a project name for a few pillars, but sharing the branding? If you know what I'm talking about.
Do you mean our the program Digital Future Society? So, it's a program that will be part of our foundation, the Mobile World Capital Foundation, which is a public foundation in Spain. And we have the three levels of government, which is a very unusual structure for our country. So, but will be an initiative led by our foundation, but to be a global initiative. So it really, you know, it's really about bringing different institutions together and creating space. And we have a privileged position within the telecommunications sector because we have the Mobile World Congress in Barcelona. We have very close relationship with the different stakeholders and with GSMA. And we want, you know, to start within that space that we already have, and really create a space for reflection, and also to position the Spain and the Spanish speaking countries to create this space of debate for to really think about the digital, but always in relation with Europe and other geographic regions of the world.
Right. So so it's mostly a I would say, because you're a foundation, a social sector institution that's supporting this endeavor, and there's no like corresponding office within the Catalonian government or the Barcelonian city council. They're more like participants to your program. Is that the idea?
Exactly. So the three levels of government we have, they are in our board of trustees as a foundation, and they meet, you know, every quarter, and we do a presentation of activities, and they give us support, but there is no physical. We have the physical office and of the foundation, but we won't have a physical space, institutionalized space for the digital future society. So we a more heterogeneous program that will be led by the foundation, but in collaboration with a lot of other institutions and support from the city council, regional government, and central government.
Yeah, the board of trustees of the foundation, of the Mobile Capital Foundation, the city council, the government of Catalonia, and the ministers of Spain, they will be also part of the global, one of the representatives of each one will be part of the global board of trustees of Digital Future Society as well. So that's the connection as well with the board of trustees of the foundation. And for us, the foundation is very important because this is the way that the Minister of Spain, Catalonia government, Barcelona City Council, they talk each other, you know. Through our foundation, it's very important because Digital Future Society also wants to do a new helps to, no, to a new legislation to become, you know, in this digital area, no? So, and that's the way that we can connect all of them, no? All the policymakers.
Exactly.
Okay, that's great. So one final question. So say that if I want to send a delegate from Taipei to the Congress, for example, and I will attach myself to them and things like that, what degree of travel and or accommodation can this project support, or have we are we supporting our own budget for traveling?
We will support all these expenses, yes. That's also
we will support the traveling, accommodation, and most
any
of
fees,
the,
exactly that you have when you are here. For example, if you come to Mobile World Congress, because in Mobile World Congress we are also we will also do a summit of Digital Future Society. We still don't know which day, but once we have all the information, if you are a member of our Global World of Trustees, you will receive an invitation, and we will support all the expenses.
That's great, because I may not be able to physically come, because it is, for example, if it's during the parliamentary inquiry session, I will have to remain in Taiwan, but I'm always able to find someone who can be a, herself or himself a very knowledgeable expert also. For example, we had a conversation around social impact investment in South Korea, and our delegation is a my predecessor, like a ex-minister for social innovation and social enterprise, but and she attended on kind of my behalf, but from the civil society, she's from academia anyway, but I appear through a mountable iPad so that I can still be part of the conversation.
Exactly.
But if this arrangement is okay to you, then I will let my civil society and academic people know that if they act as kind of my avatar or whatever, you will still be able to support the accommodation and traveling costs.
Exactly.
That's no problem.
Yeah, that will be, you know, it's already allocated within our budget, this type of costs. And you know, we know that sometimes organizations and people have to send a representative because of the agendas and other public obligations and so on and commitments. So that will not be a problem at all.
Okay. Well, in that case, I would say that I'm willing. But because of our law here, I will have to check with our HR department, the Secretary General, they have to verify first that you're a non-profit that we know about, and that the work that you're doing aligns with our national interest. So they will do some due diligence and may send you some emails. I'm quite willing to join this endeavor.
Thank you very much, Avril. And if you need any other information, additional information, or any other presentation, we can. You only have to ask, and we can send it to you. Or if you want us to talk with any other person from the government, we can arrange another call. Okay?
Okay, that's great. That's all I need. So are you okay with us just publishing this video? Because it will help. Because any other government official, I'll just point this YouTube link to them and they will understand the context of
No,
what we talk
we
about.
understand and we support that. I think it's a very good idea as well. This
Okay.
kind of
Well, then, thank you for your time. And
Okay.
let's
Thanks very much,
continue this
Gabriel.
conversation. Thank
Thank you
you.
for your time.
Thank you very much.
Cheers.
Nice day.
Bye.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye-bye.